Grace, peace, and mercy to you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. You know, this series that we began last Sunday is a series that we're calling Spring Training. And the concept that we talked about last week is an important concept for our Christian life. It is this idea that we would continue to be changed by God, that we would continue to grow in faith, that we would continue to be grown as his disciples. The word that we would find for it in our church life and theology is sanctification, right? That we would continue to be changed or sanctified by God. And in order to do that, we look to his word, kind of as was even told to the kids in the children's message. We continue to be learning and growing in how we can love more fully. And so that's what we look at today, is this topic of love and how we continue to grow in this ability to love. And today's a good day to do that, because the example even shared with the children is the example that we can talk about in our own lives of the love of a mother. Right, this mother's love that would care for us, feed us and clothe us, raise us up, a mother's love that would continue to encourage and guide us along the way, that we would then also be trained. Of course, trained by God on how to love, but also very often that training takes place even in our own home, right? How to be a parent. Well, we learn how to be a parent from our parents. And oftentimes we grow and develop in those beautiful ways. And as wonderful as those examples can be, and they are wonderful examples, we also know that something is absolutely clear and true. In fact, shared with the children as well. Sometimes in this world, because of our sin, because of the way we are in sin, is that love is hard. Even the love of a mother at sometimes can struggle. Maybe even today, as you're sitting and thinking and you're hearing about this and it's Mother's Day, maybe today is kind of a painful day because of a struggle in a relationship with your mother, or a struggle in a relationship with your children. It's not uncommon. Because sin is common, right? Sin in this world, and sin, our own sin that we struggle with at times, even on a day like today, a beautiful day, a wonderful day to focus upon the love of a mother, but also a day that can also bring some difficulty. It's this reminder that we need to grow in our ability to love. And that's why God gives us his word, this word that we focus on today. Just to make my point even maybe more clear, I hope that you would all agree with it already, this idea that we need to grow in love. But the example from our text, our reading today, describes the love that is existing and being shared by God's people, his church, right? That we would care for others, that we would love others deeply, it says. But let me give you a couple of examples of how maybe we struggle a bit with that too. In our reading, we find this example of sharing a meal with someone in need, sharing our home with someone in need. If we're gifted to speak, well then speak as if God is giving us the words to say. If our gift is helping, then help with all the power and strength that God gives us. However, you know, in our real culture today, in our community today, if someone is of need, they need a meal. They need a place to stay. The first place that they would look is probably not often the church. If they need words that would teach them, help them to grow, if they need help that is beyond all other ability to help themselves, they may not first look to the church. You know, we don't have a reputation as Christians of ones that we really know how to love, and yet right here in God's word, he's saying that we should be the place where people would go. If someone is in need, someone needs a meal, they need a place to stay, they need help, they need guidance, they need the true word of God, we should be a place that is first thought of by those in our community that don't know him. But truth is, often we're not. We become very good at loving those that maybe look like us, or loving those that can love us in return. We're really good at that. Right, if someone shows us love, well, then it's really easy to love them back. But again, as was shared with the children, when someone's kind of unlovable, or at least they seem unlovable, this is when it gets hard. And this is why we need God's word, as it describes to us exactly this way that we are to love deeply. In fact, his word, I'll read a portion of it here in just a minute. His word is very clear, in fact, very practical, as it not only just says, love one another deeply, it says, and this is how. And he gives us some examples. Before I share these examples, though, let me share a couple of examples from our confirmation students today. Right, at 10:30 service, we have four young people that will confirm their faith in Christ, and their education, their time of learning and being trained up in God's word has been, well, for the last couple of years. So on Wednesday evenings, these individuals, along with, well, probably 20 more of their classmates, they come on a Wednesday night and they have studied the word of God. Not only studying the word of God for head knowledge, but they gather together as kind of a community of young people. And they learn to apply God's word together as they have a meal together and they study the word together. They make these application events together. And boy, at times we've had to deal with some conflict among teenagers in that group. Sit down with them and they speak about forgiveness. They've had to live that out, right? To live out forgiveness, to live out love. And so their education has gone on, well, for 2 years for these individuals. And then at the end of their confirmation instruction, they have to do a project. And this project is one that's chosen by them with some help from Grace. And they live this out in some way. Let me give you some examples of how they have been training to love. First example would be Katie. Katie has, in her project, she chose to go to a regular attendance of the People City Mission. And her mom made this a Saturday routine for a number of months. And they would get up on Saturday morning and they would go there and she'd laugh because she'd talk about how they had put on hairnets and aprons, and they would create a meal, make a meal, they would clean and get everything ready. People would come in, they would serve that meal to those that needed a meal. And they would clean up after them. She met a bunch of people. She learned a lot about them. She learned about homelessness. She learned about need. And she learned, trained by God, in order to show love simply by sharing a meal. Now, Jack did something a little bit different. Jack is really good with the computer. And so Jack created a kind of like a commercial. It's a little video that's set to music, wonderfully done. And what he did is he interviewed various people within his church. And he asked them this question, why do you love your church? And they had various people giving answers about why they loved their church. He put it all together and set music to it, and we sat and watched it the other night. A beautiful example. And he pointed out that the reason he wanted to do this, so that he could put it on Facebook, he could put it on the website, is because he said, I want other people to know that God's love, even through their church, is wonderful. What a great example of him training, learning how to extend that love to other people. Well, then there was Marina. Marina, this young lady, she decided that she was going to do this event by going to a nursing home and making some friends and visiting regularly three individuals that really didn't have any family that would visit them. And so she made some good friends. And she sat day after day or week after week as she visited them routinely to learn about them, to know about them, to simply come and share her time, share her words of encouragement, share her prayers with three elderly folks that don't have a whole lot of folks visiting them. She was using her words, her gifts, her ability to extend love to those that were lonely. And then finally, we have the last one, and her name is Promise. And Promise studied various stories in Scripture, and then she created some artwork to display those stories so that she could tell others, as they look at this art that she created, she could tell them a Bible story that corresponds to the art that she made. So she used her gifts and abilities to be able to proclaim the Word of God. In her presentation that she did downstairs about a week ago, she had a line, a quote that I loved so much, because it summed up this whole process of confirmation for them. She said, I love God, I belong to Him, and to His church. That's why I want to be confirmed. It's a great statement. In fact, it's a statement that all four of these young people could speak. But they love God, they love His church, and they belong to Him and to His church. In fact, it's a statement that we would do well to make. You know, as we observe that they are confirming their faith, right? They're confirming the faith that God had given them in their baptism, and that we also might be reminded. In fact, we'll be reminded later in the service about our baptism and even confirming our faith silently in such a way to say that we could say the same thing, that we love God, that we belong to Him and to His church. Let me just pause for a second. This whole idea of belonging to God, it means that we have faith in Him and that God joined us to His family through the waters of baptism, that now we belong to Him. We are His children, and that by faith in Jesus Christ, we know that our sins are forgiven. We know that we have eternal life. And see, if this is a commitment or a statement that you could make as well, that you belong to God, well, then that's what this reading is actually focused on and for. This reading from 1 Peter, God's word is speaking to those who belong to Him. And He's giving them very specific advice on how you that belong to Him, we that belong to God, would continue to show a deep love for other people. Let me just read this in a portion of this. He says, "The end of the world is coming soon. Therefore, be earnest and disciplined in your prayers. More important of all, continue to show deep love for each other, for love covers a multitude of sins. Cheerfully share your home with those in need of a meal or a place to stay. God has given each of you gifts from His great variety of spiritual gifts, so use them well to serve one another. Do you have the gift of speaking? Then speak as though God Himself were speaking through you. Do you have the gift of helping others? Do it with all the strength and energy that God supplies. Then everything you do will bring glory to God through Jesus Christ. All glory and power to Him forever and ever. Amen." If we were to break that reading down, let me give you some very practical, simple examples that you trained up in this love because you love God, because you belong to Him and belong to His church, that you have the opportunity to simply share a meal with someone. It seems simple. It seems kind of obvious, really. But sharing a meal with someone who maybe is in need of a meal, or maybe they're just in need of your time. It's super easy. Maybe it seems intimidating. Maybe it seems like, well, you don't know that person well, or you don't really know anybody that could really need a meal, but you do. Right? In this family of faith, there's those that are lonely, that are in need, that would desire to spend time with you. Just ask. Just ask, invite someone, sit down and share a meal with them. It is an example, it's a training of showing deep love for another person. Here, the next example in the reading is, again, just as practical, it's just as simple. It says, share your home with someone who is in need. Now, this might seem really intimidating. It might seem a little shocking. In our culture today, boy, we protect our privacy. We protect our belongings. The idea of sharing our home with someone might seem kind of crazy, maybe even seem outrageous, but God's word is just really simple. It just kind of lays it out there, to share your home with someone in need. I can assure you, as one that's currently doing that now, the blessings that God provides go in every single direction. It's not just this extension of blessing another person with something as simple as a place to live or a home, right? But that blessing is returned even doubly so as you watch and develop and learn and love someone. If you are willing or interested in being trained by God in this way, please just let me know. I can connect you with others that might be doing the same. That you would be encouraged to do exactly what God's word simply says. Share a meal, maybe share your home. Now, when we read on a little bit further in this text, we find some other things. It says, share your words. If you have the gift of speaking, then speak as if God has given you the things to say. So you can share your words with someone. This is actually quite simple. But it's someone who actually wants to hear your words. Right, someone who needs to hear your word of encouragement, or someone who needs to hear your word of correction, someone needs to hear your word of forgiveness, to hear your words of love. This is how we practically love someone. Be willing to take the time to share your words with them. Or then finally, the last one that's described here is to share your gift of help to someone. There are people that need help. And maybe it's your gift or ability to fix something, and so you help them by fixing it. Or maybe it's your gift of being creative, and you help them by your creativity. Or maybe you help someone who is in need financially, or maybe you help someone that's in need physically, emotionally. Your ability to help them simply shares this training in how to love. You know, to summarize a very practical word of Scripture, it's just so very simple. God simply says, for those of you that love God and that you belong to Him and belong to His church, He gives some very specific words, words that are just so very simple to say, love one another deeply. And as you are trained to love one another, share a meal, share your home, share your words, share your help with those in need. And by the way, one of the most beautiful things that God does is He doesn't just speak those words to us. He actually gives them as an example to us. He actually displays His love for us in those very same ways. We gathered together here this morning, and God says, I'm going to share a meal with you. A meal that gives my presence. A meal that feeds you in a way that you can't be fed in any other way. He says, I'm going to share my home with you. I'm going to share my home with you here as you sit in this place. I'm going to share my home with you, God says, as ultimately He will share an eternal home with us in heaven. God says, I'll share my words with you. Read my word, study my word, hear my word. That God would continue to share His word with us and that He would help us, using His gifts and abilities to help us in ways that we can't ever help ourselves. He would help us by sending His Son, Jesus Christ, to take our sins upon Himself. Help us as we continue to grow in faith. Help us as we know forgiveness through Jesus, so that we would ultimately gather together again in eternity, sharing a meal with Him, sharing this incredible home that He has created for us, enjoying his word proclaimed, enjoying this help even for eternity. Amen.